Hello everybody and welcome to round 4 of the SRO Car Factor 1998. We're live here tonight in Portland and with me in the commentary box today is George Talbot and Wayne Reed. So George, what are your opinions on this track today?
Good evening everyone. It's a fantastic little track. It did host these cars in 1998, also hosted a bit of a ALMS. Quite short track, quite high speed, but a real driver favourite and should provide excellent entertainment for us today.
Absolutely, and there's a familiar face at the front of the field for the race, and that is Peter Enders, stars at the front of the field. He'll be looking to, once again, show another good performance today.
I think it's actually Arrow on hold, but he's just left the game, so we're hoping to have him back. Yeah, he has out-qualified Peter Enders today. Hopefully he can make it back in time.
And of course, we're actually nearing the end of the championship now, so all the drivers will want to finish as high as they possibly can to try and keep their championship hopes alive, and it's the field starting to slim down to the possibilities of who could win this.
Definitely Anders Nielsen is currently leading the title with strong performances and finishes. Now Peter Enders will be further up there if he had the issues, but yeah, definitely this will go down to the wire, but the drivers that are really in it, as I said, Nielsen, Peter Enders, Reyes Ericsson, and maybe one or two others probably looking to challenge as well.
Yeah, so, of course, you know, the whole championship can completely be turned on its head after today's race. So this could really be a championship-changing race. So, of course, just waiting for the race to get underway. And I see Peter Enders there going a little bit wide, but, again, shouldn't harm him too much. As we saw, I mean, you know, since this whole series, there's been plenty of late race action, so it's come down to the wire. So hopefully we'll see some more exhilarating action today.
Yeah, definitely with these cars being so tricky and so much power, needing a lot of skill to drive them. We've seen some really exciting races so far with the races going down to the last couple of minutes, like we saw at Road America last time out with Nielsen being caught by Tim Brook, who's not here today sadly, but Tim Brook actually took the lead on the final lap and then spun it with two or three corners to go and then gave it back to Nielsen. Yeah, just 30 seconds to go. We go to the grid for a 60-minute race. It's going to be a manual double file rolling start today, so when the lights go out, the race won't actually start. They'll the leader will control the pack around about 130 kilometers an hour, and down the back straight they should all bunch up into two by two formation. And when they get to the start line, the leader can clamp down. But it's going to be exciting into turn one here today with the interesting chicane there. You know, you can try and go down the inside there, but if the person holds the line, then you're going to be on the outside for the second half of the chicane. So I'm sure we'll see drama into the chicane today.
Yeah, hopefully, you know, we'll try and make it through safely. Is it the last thing we're going to do, especially on that one as well, when there's that many cars in such a short space of distance between them. You want to try and make it as clean as possible. I mean, it's an hour-long race, so you don't want to be there within the first few minutes.
Yeah, potentially, you'll on the opening laps. If you can stay out of trouble, you've got a great chance of fighting for a podium. It looked like we are ready to go racing here, as Matt Farrow has made it back, so making his debut in the series, and effectively his debut at SRO, or the newly formed, rebranded SRO with the new site and form, so it'll be interesting to see how he gets on today. One of the fastest drivers I've seen in sim racing, and I'm sure he'll be the favourite for today after sticking it on pole, but I'm sure Peter Enders and Co will have something to say about it. So we see the lights going out now, so they'll begin the formation lap when the lights go out.
I'm here, also stepping technical issues.
Oh. Good evening, Wayne.
Good evening. Everyone ready for an exciting evening?
It's all looking good to go as the cars will circulate around. It's a very short track. You've got a lap time of around 58 seconds, and so looking at around 58 minutes with a couple pit stops. So again, we can see how quickly pit stops are going to show a factor in this. I mean, especially in the last race as well, pit stops can actually make or break your race. So, interesting to see what guys go aggressive with strategies and what guys try and fail a bit.
Yeah, definitely. We saw at Road America, one of the fast guys, Samuel Leinonen, who can't be here today, he's in Lapland. He went for the two-stopper, where he was one of the fastest on the track, but lost so much time from pit stops and couldn't really fight for it at all, had no chance. So definitely the one-stop is the fastest, and they could just about do it with a full tank on the boost, two or three, possibly four, if they go up and down on the boost to modulate it. And yeah, as we're seeing them now come down this back straight, see how close they are to the wall. You get a real sense of speed as you drive down there. Drive should bunch up now as they head towards final corner. And here we go, we're about to see 60 minutes of racing.
So the steel bunching up, then all of them get an extremely good start. Down the home straight they come. You can see a bit of a lock up there, but the field all trying to get as close as they possibly can to one another to get a good launch off the line. The leader will get a bit of adrenaline now, and you can see
it looks like they're being a bit of confusion.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think we're going to make something on that one, but I think that's...
I think we're going to have to restart. Some people didn't quite understand. Let me see if I can.
So I think that was a very disorganised start. I think you saw the leader drop back, and maybe he thought there was going to be two warm-up laps as some races before, but obviously I think it the race does actually start at the line, so I think they will have to go through another warm-up phase. Which is, I think that will be a bit of a letdown for some drivers too, because they're after going to go through all that warm-up procedure again and get their heads back in gear and try and let everything go.
Well, we don't have to do the warm-up now. I think we can go back. It wasn't actually Matt Farah's fault. I think Peter Enders got a bit confused there and eager and went for it a bit early. I hope everyone's made it onto the grid. It looks like they have, so we should be all right. But yeah. Drama already at the start of the race, but hopefully there.
Could also be first on the nerves there. Quite tight, you're getting some wanting to go in a bit heavier than others.
I was just thinking, well, Matt Farah was doing a good job. He bunched them up nicely and held the speed and was waiting for the start line, and the top of the drivers had other ideas. I'm sure we'll get it right this time. Luckily this season we haven't had any issues with the starts. That's the first time there's been confusion, but I'm sure they'll get it right this time.
Well, fingers crossed then. So of course they will do one more warm-up lap of this Portland circuit. And I mean, it'll be interesting to see, I think, especially it's going to be frustrating for Matt Farah seeing all the cars jumping before him and getting a bit lost in that. And I think some of the cars, especially Jose Mura as well, in second, was looking to get a good start and seeing all that the rest of the put him in the light.
Yeah, it's going to be going through Matt's head. He's put the car on pole, was probably relaxed and ready for a race, and the car is going down into turn one, and he's probably thinking in his head, what the hell is everyone else doing?
It would have shaken me up, to be honest.
As you can see from the cameras and the shots, we've got some excellent camera angles here. I'm being told that the volume is low. I don't know whether that's the cars or us. If someone could type me on TeamSpeak, that'd be good. But I'll hand over to Liam to start the race.
Yeah, so on to the home straight they come then. Hopefully there won't be any mistakes this time in two lanes. So side by side they come. Matt Farah from Jose Mura then will lead the field in towards turn one. And how is this race going to pan out? 60 minutes of racing is about to get underway. The engines are roaring, and across the line they come. And we're on the way to the might be wrong. on the opening lap, followed by Mohamed Bouffal, who's had a great start.
I think it was Jay Morrall. He's a spinner.
Oh, yeah, so Morrall just dropped down the timings. But I didn't see what happened, though, with Farrow and Endes coming out of turn one, I believe. There seemed to be a bit of contact. And, yeah, definitely something happened between Endes and Farrow. But Farrow flying away. We can see now Patel's in second. Great start for him. Looks like that is...
Sucking back in. What will be interesting, we can see if there was... Some sort of
yeah, I don't think it'll be too bad. I just need to remember not to to fix it in the stop. Otherwise, that's going to be extra time wasted in the pits. It won't actually fix that much on the car. We can see Endes now all over the back of Patel. He's going to want to get past Patel straight away. Otherwise, this is playing right into the hands of Matt Farrow, who looks like he's already put the gun down and worked away hard. This is the best opportunity. Get a slipstream down the turn and start. Run, dangerous place to overtake, but it can be done. Doesn't look like he's close enough.
And this is going to be the man try. We've seen him make some spectacular moves in the past, and it looks like they both went a bit wide there and touched the gravel slightly. But onto the home straight they come, and let's see if Ennis can maybe get a move to the chicane. And there's Nilsson, one of your main championship contenders, in fourth position again, looking very comfortable. We saw the other week how, you know, he can sit there quite quietly, you know, unnoticeable, no overtaking as well, and getting some of the runners still finishing the top row. Right at the rear of the end of the road.
Yeah, something's happened to Ericsson. Yeah, right at the back of the field. Well, Jose Moore.
Oh, he's done it again. Ericsson's on the grass, and that is not the way he wants to start this race. 55 minutes left, but it's not looking good now for Ericsson. He's right at the rear. He's got 11 starts to be able to win, and he's going to have to run 50 more. So, he's trying to make his way to win as possible, but it's been done.
Joyce, I
held off Endes, he's not as close as he was before. Matt Farrow is high at the moment, he's had a fast sector, pretty decent sectors 2 and 3, and his last lap was 2 tenths quicker than Mohamed Bouffal, although Peter Endes matched him on that last lap.
He's got a very hungry Nilsson just behind him. He's not too far behind either. So the top four all within a couple of seconds of each other. You can see the toe goes wide and he's got the train slightly.
Nearly a second off the time he should be doing. Missed that mistake from him. Meanwhile, I think at the back they're still fighting.
Here we go.
The championship leader is currently in all-time leaders. We see it now. He hasn't been blocked by the second and third place men. He can still just about win the toe from Peter Endes. So Nilsson stayed out of trouble. Excellent job here so far.
We've got Joe says that to make a move on Danny.
That's Weeks in the wall. Is that
yeah, that was Jordan Weeks. We watch replay now.
Yeah, he is. He's in the wall. I'm not sure what happened there, but he's completely out of the race. You see the engine's on fire, wheels missing, and wind as well. So I'm guessing maybe a bit of contact that's something flying in the opposite direction.
Yeah, it looked like he got too close, I think, to Max Ericsson, and all the way he can't overtake him. And who's that? Danny Lovers making his debut.
And that's
so
somehow I'm going to get unscathed for that one, but I believe, yeah, that was Richard Soblowski, and that's not going to help it.
what happened there with the spin, but he got down the field and it's quite a feisty little pack as well at the moment.
Yeah, I'm not sure who he was side by side with coming out of turn one, but yeah, definitely a little bit of contact there. He needs to calm down a little bit. He's a bit too aggressive and fighting over the track, but it's so narrow, just from the lap. The draft that these guys will all be getting is one of Richard now. He's got 3-4 cars all ahead of him to come into this really high speed second to last corner, using all the track everyone there. You see kicking up the dust. And yeah, it really is tight here, but everyone needs to settle down. There's still 50, just over 51 minutes to go. We caught his accident. Looks like Peter Enders has made a mistake because Anders Nilsson, who we were just talking about minding his own business, is now right on the back of the tail. And now up to third place. Something has happened to Enders on the last lap. Fat Barrow flying away. He's already got a 4.5 second lead back to second place now. It's full of Nilsson. Very, very short. Getting a turn all the way down here.
Things with Nilsson, he's really the most exceptional guy. He just really keeps himself to himself, as we've said. He just doesn't go looking for trouble or trying to make the right moves or doing, you know, amazing defensive moves. What's the leader? So he's just a good lap line. In turn, that sort of leads him towards the front of the field.
Yeah, definitely you've got to be in it, but it looks like Richard Sobolewski has geared in as well. I see what's happened to lost it out of power and into the wall.
The fire is already, and there's, well, 10 guys left, I believe.
We've got Jose and Matt Strand having a battle now.
Yep, 7th and 8th place overall. Danny Lovers in front of them, so it's 6th, 7th and 8th. Danny Lovers, Matt Strand and Jose Mora. But Matt Strand taking
Ericsson
a different line there.
So, yep. I mean, of course, Ericsson and Mora have had their fair share of battles in the past. Let's see what Strand can do then to defend the Jose Mora.
I don't think he'll be close enough, brakes a little bit late, but he's going to really be alongside there to make the pass, but he should be able to get the run now down into turn one, although it looks like Ericsson's caught them a lot, so Ericsson's going to get a double toe here.
I was expecting more of a fight back there, to be honest.
Yeah, I think Matt Strand got a compromised exit and that allowed Mora to go around him and he got the power down, but now it'll be Matt Strand who's going to have to defend from Ericsson behind him. Ericsson obviously wanting to make up for Ericsson, you can see him there get sideways, just power down and he lost some less than moments ago. Meanwhile, back in front, the lead's now up 2.5 seconds. Matt Farrow on his return to SRO and sort of new debut, leading 5.4 seconds now. Tell in second, Nilsson in third, fourth place is Mark Foley. Haven't seen any of them today, so he's got up. He's got a, his mirror's full of Enders, so something has happened to Enders again. He's gone from fourth to fifth as we see him make the pass there with inches to spare. Great driving there from Enders. Enders back up to four now with Foley back down to fifth. What will Foley have to say about this?
Those errors will be in the back of your mind for the rest of the race, and you'll just do everything you can to not make them again, and in turn it could make you make even more.
Matt Farrow's an absolute flyer this late. He's just taken the gut up to 6.0 seconds.
Yeah, he really is right at the front. He's dominated at East Car Quarter, another league that I've raced with him, and yeah, he's just really, really good at these. So I think for the next round people are going to have to step up their game to really take the fight to him. Got a long way to go.
That's maximum points for a driver that isn't really in the title today. Yep. You know,
well, this is the person this is benefiting most is the man that we're watching at the moment, Anders Nilsson, championship leader. He's got Mohamed Patel in front of him, he's not really a rival, he's got too many DNFs. Peter Enders, he's behind him at the moment, making mistakes. So yeah, this is really benefiting Nilsson. Enders needs to beat Nilsson today to try and claw back some points. But he's not too far off, so Enders looks like he's stepped up the pace because he's dropped Foley already. Foley had nothing, really. And we watch him there getting a tag slap on. Manages to hold on to it.
So, just over
45
minutes remaining then as Danny Lubbers starts to defend his position.
Fantastic.
Atlantic Racing Team, him and Peter Enders will be looking for decent points haul today. Shella Stenback is not racing today, so Anders Nilsson's teammate isn't in, so this is an opportunity for Atlantic to stake their claim on the championship if both drivers can make it to the end. Still a long way to go in this race.
He's really on a fly this race.
I mean, it's good to see as well. I mean, especially if he keeps that performance up towards, you know, the end of the season, going into the last few rounds now.
I believe that was Matt Strand there in ninth place with the big slide in the final corner. See a great shot now, turn one. Sticking with Patel, he's only about half a second behind. You see 0.7 of a second behind, closed a little bit on that lap. This is going to be a three-way battle for seconds. This is going to help Farrow out in the front even more, as these three drivers will swap for second place. I'm sure Nilsson won't put up too much of a fight. He's thinking about this championship, so if Enders starts looking feisty behind him, I'm sure just won't put up too much fight. Won't make it easy for him, but he doesn't want any contact or damage or DNF so far on his excellent campaign that Nilsson's had.
Brilliant. The thing is, especially for general people, it's so hard to allow the pressure of being in a title hunt to get to your head. You need to try and Nilsson's doing a good job of that.
Yeah, we definitely.
Well, that thing's going to be long before Williams passed Matt and it's all climbing all over the back of him. This is Matt's all set all over.
Well, that's what major handling issues it seems. So let's see what he's looking quite handy at the moment. And those at the back of the field. So as long as you finish, he gets to pick up a few points.
Yeah, definitely. Brand doesn't normally get the time to put in as much practice as he would like. He's got a very busy schedule, but great to see him out finding the time to enjoy himself in some race. But it looks like Williams going for the inside.
Fight his car and almost wrestle it around the track just to try and wait for him to make a mistake, not like that. The stringer goes very wide there, and it's, I think it's a bit too much curve and lost the back end side. The stringer's going to try and claim onto the back of Strand, put a bit of pressure on and see what happens.
And this is also pulling on the
gap. Yep, now down to 0.6, I believe. No, still 10.7, so staying about the same, although he looks like he's closing up a lot into turn one, although I think that's just the concertina effect. We see Patel obviously can get the power down before Nilsson, but yeah, Nilsson can get a good run on to the back straight and hold into the final two corners then. you'll be able to get him down into turn one the next lap. That's how short the lap is here. You're almost planning a move, you know, so early on, because this track here is like one massive second of another track. It's such a short track.
To the back.
Yeah.
Because it's, you know, all the corners, as you say, it's quite combined, it's roughly a minute a lap, so it's a very quick circuit, it's not a slow sort of having time to think in between corners, it's a constant concentration. And it'll be interesting to see just how many of the drivers will maybe start to pull out the concentration and put people in the wall.
Something's happened to Mr. Ericsson. We watch a replay now. It's like
he's lost the back end, obviously, a lot of nose.
Matt Strand's been off as well.
So yeah, Matt Strand has had an incident as well because he's lost the position.
I think they're all starting to feel the pinch a bit now. They're realising that pushing that little bit too far is going to cost them a lot of places. But obviously, there'll be a short lap, one spin, you know, 10, 15 seconds, a quarter of a lap behind them.
Well, these three is Nielsen and Enders now, so Enders is caught Nielsen more than Nielsen's caught Patel, so this will give Patel the chance to put in a few fast laps. As we see last time round, the fastest man was actually Peter Enders, who was a couple of tenths quicker than Farrow. So Farrow may be easing off a little bit, although he's still in the top three for the fastest lap. So Matt Farrow doesn't ease off too much and make a mistake that lots of drivers say that they find that they can't ease off, because that's how the mistakes kick in. So.
Well, we should also start seeing the pit stops coming into play now. So what, lap 19, 20 now?
If anyone's going for an alternative pit stop, I reckon we would see them now. It's still about 10 minutes to go. We're expecting a mad rush into the pit lane. Looks like it's over here. Again, sensible driving here from Enders.
And it's weird, like, they want to take the most of the ground in the very close test for Enders. He's desperately trying to find a manoeuvre as quick as possible round the outside, and, well, Nielsen sort of lets that one go. He's totally all bumping away.
Yeah, Nielsen got an awful exit out of turn one, and Enders almost drove into the back of him. Luckily avoided him, and, yeah. Sort of
interesting thing now is whether Pete Enders would make any difference.
Yeah, well, on paper, he is quicker than Patel, so catch up to the back of him and pass him quickly. Then we can try and see if Enders can push hard to catch Farrow, but it's going to be a big ask. That's still 39 minutes to go, so anything's possible, as we've seen in these car factor races, with the leads changing so many times in the previous races. It's strange to see someone out running, filling a gap and dominating.
So he's not too far behind as well, to be honest. I mean, Patel somehow isn't too far off Farrow either, so I think Farrow's just taking it easy now. He's got the gap he wants, he's around 9 seconds, so he can just maybe take his foot off the accelerator.
I don't know, looking at his last lap time, he was still 9 tenths of a second past Patel. Patel had a slow one the last time around.
He's also got Andreas Eriksson showing his strength with Trangas.
Too many mistakes today. One for him to get up to the podium now. He's already 37 seconds back from the leader, and the more time he spends in traffic, the more he's going to lose the top three. So it's going to be a big ask for Ericsson. We know he's got the ability and the speed, but to know he hasn't been himself today.
Of course, he's still got Max Strand struggling out the back of the second. He's probably got the right hand. Sitting there thinking he's driving a Minardi this week. Oh, Ericsson off again. chicane straight across the grass. Coming to the end of the lap there. I think he's needs to calm himself down. I think he sort of proved his overtake manoeuvres at best are somewhat misjudged. I think he needs to find his head again.
Yeah, well, he's a previous winner in this series. He got the hat trick at Daytona on his debut, pole position, fastest lap around the winners. It looks like that's Ringers is off, I believe.
Yep, yeah, he's gone wide on the grass. He's still come back, he's lost about 4 seconds there.
Yep, so that gives place up to Ericsson, who's now got a bit of clear track. He's 7.2 seconds behind Danny Lovers in 7th. So, opportunity now, we'll see how fast Andreas is. We'll update you on his next lap time to see if he has got anything in the tank to catch the top three.
He's probably over the back of the tail as well, and he's going to be looking forward to see something from him. Dropped Ericsson, not last week's team.
Nelson. I'm lucky with Andover, so I'm used to it, yeah. A lot of similar Swedish names. It looks like Endless held to that quite much.
Maybe they're going to drive on the nerf on the inside.
It's cheeky, it's actually going to drive as well. It looks like the inside of Alain Patel is going to have the moving. Patel goes wide. I think if I'm honest, it's worked out best for both drivers because I'm thinking there would have been some inevitable contact there.
No, I think Endless is definitely the plan, so Patel. Defending his hard as he could, but defended it too hard and brake too late. Let's wait on to see how close they get to the wall and how close he gets under braking. I thought he was going to go to the back of him there.
The next question is what it takes to bring him up.
That's a huge ask. As we see their last lap time found, actually Patel and Enders were quicker than Farrow, but only by 0.4 of a second. But I suppose that's quite a lot on a short track like this, so. I don't know if Farrow made a bit of a mistake or he's struggling with his tyres, but it's not impossible. The gap is 8.9 seconds. So yeah, with slow pitch and off speed and anything like that, it's so once again, great action in the SRO Car Factor 98 series.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, seeing as well with Enders, you can see how hard he was pushing when he was on the back of the tail, just by the amount of cars sliding in there as well is another example. He really is pushing the car to the absolute limit here.
Yeah, definitely. He needs to cut out those mistakes because those really won't help him because it's just put Patel right on the back of him. He looked like he did some pretty decent sectors, Enders that arc right now. He was 0.3 faster than Farrow in sector 1, 0.2 faster in sector 2, but then lost nearly half a second in the last sector. He ended up being a tenth slower and more on that lap. So all the hard work on the first two sectors were just thrown away by that mistake.
We've got Matt Strands past William Trengas again as well.
So Ericsson being off again then. What is going on, Mr. Ericsson? What is going on to that red visor?
It's frustration, I think he's got to the extent he's had that, you know, a few offs. More accidents again. As I say, you can't drive with a dirty mind.
Well, it depends what you're looking at. And anyway, we'll save that for another day. Yeah. We'll save that for Simon Smith when hopefully he comes and helps out in one of these broadcasts so I can go and race.
So right now, Farrow's still got a lead. There's still half an hour left. That gap for Farrow and see, you know, a late 10-minute battle, it would be extremely interesting to see what kind of pace Farrow has and what, you know, whether he has going to take to be a major factor in deciding the championship. Even if he can't win it, he can still potentially put someone out for him.
Gap is 10 seconds now, so he's got some issues now. He's shown glimpses of being the fastest man, although we don't know how hard Farrow's pushing it. These two are getting up close to the first.
Ericsson has just had a moment turn again.
Yep, dropped back again.
He's not looking good right now, although he isn't too far behind P9, but I think he's just got to try and work out the mistakes, get a fresh mind. And then maybe during the pit stop, suppose we go for an end stop, just sit, cool down for a good 10 seconds or so, and then get back out there and do what you know you can do.
Yeah, I think that's the best you can think of is about a fifth or a sixth place.
Just about to say the same thing. I think it's damage limitation. I think you need to start looking at now to protect his championship position.
That's it's Nilsson that's leading. Well, we'll brief you better next time. We'll cement some names into your head.
Might be an idea. I don't know, I bet you don't get this at the BBC.
No, that's great. I wish these two would drive different liveries. They're a bit similar. It probably doesn't look similar, but I'm watching the stream PC, which is honestly like watching a colour TV from 1971 with a ridiculous resolution. It really is hard sometimes to see what's going on, but it's inadequate, but it's difficult. I apologise if you get the name wrong. Sometimes it looks like Mark Foley has had a bit of an incident and dropped down to 7th place, and see if we can get a replay here as to what actually happened. I don't know, we might be a bit late. Yeah, missed that one with the replay, but yeah, he's now down to 7th. Danny Lubbers up to 6th. And Anders Nilsson, don't know if he has hit it. No, he hasn't, but there's been a mistake there because we've missed this somehow. Jose Mora is up to 4th, so Nilsson down to 5th. So he's heading off somewhere. He wasn't racing anyone at the time, so I don't think that's an incident with someone else, just a single driver incident. So I'll have to ask him after the race what happened there.
He seems to have lost a bit of time. I'm not sure that he's got a substantial to lose what he's lost.
Yeah, well, no drivers have pitted yet. Well, Enders has taken a second out of Farrow. The lead is now down to 9 seconds. Farrow now. Second place,
really
man. Enders. Yep.
Definitely trying to work it. I mean, Farrow's had a fairly simple race at the moment. He hasn't had any problems with traffic or anything, hasn't yet. But that will be interesting to see when he comes up to the likes of Foley and people who will end up possibly battling for position when he gets there. And how he will try and manoeuvre through that one.
Well, Jose Mora, last lap, was the fastest man by about 3 to 4 tenths of a second. Patel had a shocker of a lap last time round. Will Mora catch Patel? And it looks like Danny Lubbers has had a bit of damage. I'm not sure. There we go, yeah, we catch the replay there. A bit of a slide. Goes through one of the signs. That won't be too bad for him, but definitely lost the position back. Foley, who had previously made a mistake, gets 6th place back. Let's see, we're into the pitting territory. You mentioned that before being a track. This track will be out 30 drivers out today. It will be an enormous factor in this race, but too many out today. But Farron can already see the back. That would be Andreas Eriksson, I'm guessing, because Eriksson is showing 52 seconds behind Matt Farron. This is before they pitted, so that really does show how much of a bad race Eriksson has had today. Farron doesn't look like he is pitting, so he goes for another lap.
Eriksson and Trengas are getting close again, but then Eriksson keeps falling back when he's caught up to him, so it'll be interesting to see where these three are pulled off.
Yep, well, we've just hit first man in the pits, Danny Lubbers, so he's now down into 10th.
Yep, so that means Eriksson's actually got a position, so that's really good. So maybe even use, I know only a huge one, but he uses the psychological advantage that he has given. I mean, this is potentially a
good story. No, I think it's the bad result today. That I think with Nilsson up in 5th, it's not, you know, the worst situation, but Nilsson outscoring Eriksson is not best to see someone else going into
Matt
the
Strand,
pits there. Yeah, that's Matt Strand. Let's see what the pit stop
Eriksson
time
is. Eriksson
is
at the inside.
That looks like a simple pass.
Oh, no, he's not.
No, he's lost it under.
Back wheel, put him into
don't think he's going to be very pleased with that manoeuvre. But then he's like,
again, Eric's in the walls. There's good news there, though, by accident, but just unfortunate there that he's been punted off.
Yeah, but we just saw the replay there. I think it was Vegas that then got a bit excited and took too much curve and ended up ploughing into the side of Ericsson. So Ericsson didn't lose it under power. He did actually suddenly got hit. It looks like Trigger's there doing a
I think the best thing to do is try and stay out. If he's got the speed to build up, because obviously he's going to have lost a few seconds to Matt there, I think if he can stay out with the warm tyres, he might be able to sit back and go and jump back either towards the coming out of the pit.
Yep, well, the leader has not pitted yet with 20, just over 26 and a half minutes to go. So, obviously, maybe not using as much boost as the other drivers. He may have a shorter pit stop than the other drivers. Last time round, he was about 0.5 or 6 of a second faster than Enders, so the team should really have this under control.
Enders is still trying to pluck away, but I mean, it's not a huge amount, so you see the gap down to 8.7 seconds-ish, so it will take a few tenths during the lap, but as you mark, Foley again has been looking good, but right now there's Nilsson leading the pit lane, so down in sixth position now.
Ericsson's off, he's gone again, he's had a big on this time. Big tank slapper coming into the chicane at the end of the lap, straight across, more or less right the other side of the track.
Oh yeah.
No, that was me failing there, but Nilsson is the first man to pit from the front runners. He lost one position, he should get that back when Foley comes into pit again. It looks like second place man Enders is in the pit. If I can find him, here he is. He's done his pit stop and he's off running again.
And we've now got round 15 of the Ericsson and Trengas battle. It's back to stations. I think Ericsson's going to have to pit. His tyres are absolutely coming to pieces. Just at every turn he's going round, he's just the arse ends about the place.
Yeah, well, we see the race leader at this time. Doesn't look like. Is he going for it?
Last minute
pull into the pits. One of the first boxes gets it stopped. I didn't see what time Enders had.
Turns back past again. Oh, he's had a tank slap into the final turn, but he's kept it. Yeah. I think this is like one of your race phrases last week. Got the Chucky Brothers.
What he needed in front of them, these two battling, someone around the vehicle driving there, but this is where Patel needed to clean track and put the hammer down. So we've had Matt Farrow pit, so Patel and Mora have stayed out. So Farrow and Enders have both pitted. It looks like the gap between Farrow and Enders has actually got bigger in those pit stops.
Which is exactly what Farrow needed, but what Patel doesn't need is being stuck behind Ericsson, but at the moment, of course, Ericsson should be as soon as possible, and does, but almost as well.
I just think that's the track being so narrow, but Ericsson was kind there and gave him room. That's an awesome shot there, as you see the cars flying through that chicane.
Yosh Hayes in to the pits.
Yep, so that was second place man. We see him coming in now. That also coming to pits. That Trigger's. Yeah.
Oh, he's gone off in the first turn. Completely missed the chicane, sitting on the gravel.
Ouch. Well, here's Farrow as he pushes up. And so Patel is still leading. So obviously being a bit tighter with the fuel than everyone else.
Ericsson's retired.
Somebody's that's not good to see, as we see there. Yep, Mr. Ericsson is sitting in the pits. That's not good to see. Just over 22 and a half minutes to go. Race still very much up for grabs. But as you know, the gap in Farrow and Enders is down to 7.4 seconds, so some time was then lost by Farrow, who had a slow last lap, although it's hard to tell because he did pit last lap, so we'll see his next time round. And Patel will get his time up. Now he's increased the gap a little bit, but he needs to be going a lot faster than this. He's going to need a lot more than 12 seconds to be able to hit. Still be leading.
Matt Strand in one of the worst places.
Yes, yeah, so Strand is going to run a lot of way. Stand for him to finish Enders, that's the fastest lap, which is a sight that Faro won't want to see too often.
Thing is, the thing we got to sit here and wonder is what's Matt Faro got in reserve for the lap times he's been sitting.
Well, the time that he's been there is pretty suggested that I was running a similar boot step, but I still think the power has got that little bit more. If he wants to step up, it really would be exciting in this last 21 minutes to see if Farrow can be caught by Enders. It'd be really exciting to have a battle for the last 5 minutes that we have been treated to in previous races. So Enders, as we have come to notice in our SRO broadcasts of late, always seems to be fighting for wins. He's either blowing engines or lifting trophies, so let's hope he's lifting a trophy today, but will it be the top step at the podium, second or third? Yep, so Patel with a bit of a slower pit stop there, nearly 15 seconds. I think the other guys were 11 or 12. As we see, Jose Mora has now set the fastest lap of the race, so because it's such a short lap, the fastest lap is just blind between all the different drivers. It looks like Patel has just come out right in front of Mora. So before the pit stops, he was like 4 or 5 seconds behind, but Mora's been flying. Normally found something that some of the other drivers don't have at the moment.
Well, around the inside and almost, he's trying to sweep it, but more you could see for like all the way in the back of Patel trying to duck inside, weaving, running control as well. And he's just trying to duck it, trying to move them out around the tunnel, but he just can't quite get it together. He's caught in the last step of the road, he's trying to move a good role here, and it's really going to come down to it. I mean,
There's, I think he's done an outstanding job today when you consider he was right at the back of the field at the start after.
Yeah. Definitely going to be up there for driver of the day nomination. Fantastic, yeah. Great point when you made. You saw him at Stone Cold last, I believe, after an incident on the first lap. It's a great fight back to see him. Although Matt Power has just set the swapping times at the top. Him and Enders for fastest first sector, 27.1 for Power last time round. So the lifetime, it just looks like it's updated, but the lead is now only around 7 seconds from first and second. As we see Mora trying to go around the outside.
Well, I think you need a bit of a sticky target, I think there's a certain speed there. It's a bit hit there. I don't know where the bumps are off in the gas, but I don't know if it's a single seat, it's a bit there he goes.
Yeah, well, Faro, as we just saw, as we were talking before, fast snap of the race, first man into the 58.
And again, no, I have the same technique, but it's only good to go down the outside, but he's going to finish.
It's a scary angle watching it like this. Patel's taking a defensive line, and it looks like Mora is trying to take a fight out of the back of that rear wing on that car in front of him. It's really, really interesting to watch this camera angle. You can see how narrow and tight this pack is. Really technical, high speed. Can't afford to make any mistakes, otherwise, the lap comes front. It looks like Patel's got it down straight.
I'd say that Patel's probably thinking in his mind that George is chasing him, with an out of box that George is having at the minute.
Yeah,
Patel seems to just... I think what he needs to do is try and maintain composure, hold the race in line. If not, then he's going to try and make Mora work, which is pretty good at the moment. I think Mora's going to be getting a bit frustrated if that happens.
He's got 30, he's got down the order, he's now in 8th. We just saw a replay of him coming out the pits, but he's had a few mistakes, and because he was up in 5th and 6th before, I think 6th trading places with Danny Lubbers, so that longer stint for Foley hasn't appeared to have worked, as he's dropped quite a bit down the order.
We see them. Matt Farrow's got the average back up to 7.9.
Yeah, he's turned it up again. He's quite a few tenths quicker each lap. Seeing more of this kind of big closer. Is he going to be brave? Patel's going defensive.
He's just jumped to 8.5, so he's just done an astonishing lap there.
Enders has made a mistake. Suddenly all the tyres have worn off already, because he was over a second slower on a 59-second lap. Enders a second slower than Farrow. So as I said before,
perhaps in turn one, Murray's going to try to sweep the outside. He's not quite got enough. But look how close he's getting to the back. He's going to almost lay off the corner. He's going to be really down in the past. You know, use these tyres to the full potential until he's got behind the car. I mean, essentially, he should be catching Farrow at an alarming rate. He might do it in the time then, but it's a bad thing for him. He's pushing so hard. Putting quite decent lap times, but of course being held up by Patel is kind of limiting the potential of the tyres.
They're also going to take into consideration the way they're racing at the moment. Nelson's slowly starting to creep up. They've got enough time to do it. Sitting there waiting for something to happen.
Yeah, well, it's still 16 minutes to go. He's only 3.4 seconds behind them, so definitely possible. His lap time is pretty competitive. It's Mora and Farrow that are flying at the moment.
These two, I'll tell you, I'll have to look, change them off.
We see Foley now and Strand battling for 7th and 8th. Yeah, well, for Hamid, we've seen in multiple leagues that he is a fantastically fast driver. You don't always see him make it to the end. There's normally an excuse or a crash or some sort of failure of hardware or the actual human being failing inside his head. But today, driving beautifully, not the fastest man on the track, but really good defensive driving here. Great respect as well. I'm going to say more on being shy to himself, not smashing it down the inside. Pleasure to watch these two as we see them jumping over the grass, using as much of the track as they can. It's like a poor exit there for
Mora. They're both showing considerable car control now. They've got to be pushing against each other as well. As experienced myself for these, they're not exactly the easiest of things to move around this track.
Yep.
I seem to remember the picture of all that time in calendar months. They're both seem to be running similar, and not one of them has got their head, did they? Really?
Well, Mora seems to be a lot faster in sector one. We can see from this camera angle, they're taking chunks again out of the back of the tunnel. They get to the straight, and he does not have it. Obviously, running contrasting setups here.
That's also that's got a bit of stability in the corners, whereas one is running for speed down the straights.
Yeah, well, we've got to see Patel better speed. Awesome shot there, as we see them really struggling to come out on the start finish straight. And we tap it to Strand.
He's racing with that phone there. With
so, just under 15 minutes to go, then it's been a. That's been a very interesting race, to say the least. And again, it seems to be all the situation now. It's going to come down to the end. I mean, this race is still very much.
Yep, the lead at the front still only it's at 7.2 seconds. It's just come down a bit, so I don't know if there's been a mistake made by Farrow, but it's not as high as it was. And Ender's not really catching him quick enough. Farrow had a slow lap time last time round, and Enders is about 4/10 of a lap faster than Farrow, but we've seen this a bit too much. No one's apart from Farrow, no one's been consistently fast. The only other person that's consistently fast is Mora, but he, as Wade said, had the issues at the start, and it'd be interesting to see if Mora hadn't gone off at the start, you know, how close he would be as he looks for the inside.
Eerie.
He had to take the curves to avoid contact.
So I think he was a bit ambitious there on hearing the fat lady singer. Hammer will be enjoying the break there, might be able to settle back into a bit more of a rhythm just for all of the left or two. It'll be interesting to see if we complete the gap. He's got the outright pace of the two.
Well, we're watching the race leader here, this is Matt Barrow, first overall, second place man, Peter Enders, all his way back up to second. Hopefully, he can try and catch Barrow to give us a battle for the lead, but it's not looking likely with 12 minutes to go, third place. Last 10 minutes, these two have calmed down a bit now. We're expecting it to be back up and running just as intense as it was a couple of laps ago. Third place man Patel, Mora in fourth, other Atlantic Racing driver, Peter Anders today. Fifth place man is Anders Nilsson, Steady Eddie, should be his new name, just trying to secure this championship. Sixth place is, I believe, Danny Lovers. On his debut, looks like he's going to get some decent points. Shouldn't come under any pressure from Foley, who's over 11 seconds behind. In 7th, he's got past Matt Strand in 8th. And 9th place man, our last runner, is William Tringers on his debut as well today.
I mean, I think overall, other than a few minor incidents, I think that they've all raced quite cleanly today as well, which round here is not an easier thing to achieve.
Yeah, well, it just goes to show you don't need huge grids to have huge excitement. As we've seen, only I believe it was 12 took to the grid, so it's a shame that we have so many non-shows, but it really does show that the quality of driving and drivers on offer today has been very, very high. So we've seen them race wheel to wheel on such a short high speed track without smashing door to door in touring car style, so big respect to all the drivers today.
It's also looking like Mohamed Patel seems to be keeping the stable gap there, so I don't know whether it's going to be a decent sit and wait if he's going to form an attack right at the end, or whether Mohamed's got his pace.
Yeah, well, ever since Mora took the interesting line through turn one, or the evasive action, whatever you want to call it, over the curb, he's struggled. He hasn't been able to catch back up, and the gap has been getting bigger. Yeah, I'm not quite sure if he took on some damage or he's just, you know, destroyed his tyres. The gap is now like 1.6, 1.8 seconds on the screen.
This is show. As they say, it's racing.
Yeah, well, it's
very close to being elite as well.
Yeah, but it's in a very strange way that no one settled into a trend of being slightly faster than anyone else, only Barrow at the front. And everyone else sort of is quick for five laps. Looks like they're going to fight their way up to second and then drops off again. So I don't know if the tyres are overheating or if the setups mean they're using them at different rates. Yeah, but it's really, really strange and difficult to keep track of.
In the end, by the way, he's got to look at his steps to where he's got to from where he was. Still an achievement.
Definitely.
It's a big ask. The size and the complexity of it as well.
Well, the lead, as we've been watching these two, gap out down to 5.5 seconds. So Farrow had a slow lap last time round. I think that could have been the traffic in front of him. He was half a second slower than Enders. Let's see if he puts Hammers down again to try.
There's 8 minutes left, and I mean, is he looking at maybe 7-8 more laps maximum? So it's still very possible. I mean, there's a 6 second gap, so you know, maybe Farrow slows down a bit or Enders takes up a notch one more time, then we could perhaps see a last minute traffic. It's a big push, but it always seems to come down to the wire in these races.
Yeah, but I think we just saw with that later split that came up, Harrow only lost time because of that back marker. Once he cleared him in the third sector, he then put time on Enders again. So, let's see, can Peter Enders dig deep and to find another gear. He will have a fiddle with the boost, although we haven't seen him managing his engines very well in this championship. But engine blown at Daytona and an engine blown last time out at Road America, I believe. No, he was the winning man. No, I'm completely lost. Mr. Nilsson won at Road America. I think he did blow his engine.
We could see Jose have a little bit of benefit here with the back marker coming up.